With football season underway, NBC2's Sean Martinelli found a fan with a very unique connection to the NFL.
Sean takes us to Cape Coral for tonight's story to share.
At Cape Coral Hospital, material handler Chet Ballard keeps stuff stocked. It's a big role for a big guy.
The first time I met him, I was deathly afraid of him. Because he was this big, burly guy, and I'm like, ooh, he looks mean.
But coworkers eventually learned.
Chet is amazing.
He's more like a teddy bear, or in Chet's case, a Chicago bear.
The Bears.
The Bears.
Bear down, Chicago Bears.
Long before Chet worked at the hospital, he worked with the Bears in a job unlike any other.
Right up in this corner, right up here, is where I sat with the coaches.
It's almost hard to believe.
It really is.
When he was just a teenager, Chet landed a gig with the Chicago security company, Andy Frayne. He still has his uniform.
Jake got a hold of the hat and tore it up. Look at him sitting there.
I told him, I said, you're going to be on TV today.
Yeah, Jake.
While on assignment at Soldier Field, the Bears needed someone to escort visiting coaches throughout the stadium.
So I said, okay, I'll do it. And from that day forward, from 1982 to 1997, I was the only one that ever did that job.
Earning Chet a title.
Mayor of Bears Alley.
For 15 years, the mayor accompanied every visiting coach, hung around legendary players, and even made the occasional television appearance.
We saw a rather angry Mark Wilson, who usually has...
When Chet left the Bears in 97, he left the job to his brother Tom.
It just got to the point where we were always telling these stories that I said, why don't we just write a book?
So they did, titled Sidelines, Four Decades of Sundays with the Bears. Many of those stories cannot be shared on TV, but rest assured, the guy who stocked shelves stocked up a whole lot of memories.
Yes, he talks about them a lot.
Initially, you know, he would start telling me the stories one by one, and then I'd be seeking him. I'm like, hey, what kind of story you got for me today?
And no matter who you root for, when Chet tells a tale, bear down and listen.
That's what I want, is people to read this and just say, I can't believe these two guys got away with all this stuff all these years.
In Cape Coral, Sean Martinelli, NBC2.
I got to buy the book because I want to know the stories they couldn't tell on television.
There you go. That's some good marketing right there.